Our today's crime story is about a rapist. A rapist who raped more than 200 women. Disbalance in a society leads to crime, and the same thing happened in India, Delhi. Akhriya Daff, a rapist of about 300 women, thought that he was untouchable. No one has courage to touch him, because of the unbalanced society rules and social taboos. He had support from both the police and part of the society. Eventually this led to hacked off his penis with a knife by one of his alleged victims in the courtroom. Bharat Kalacharan, alias aka Akhriya Daff, was an alleged rapist and murderer in India. Akhriya Daff was born in 1972. The 32-year-old serial rapist had also murdered three people and dumped their bodies on the railroad tracks. He was the symbol of fear for the people of Kastabunagar, India, almost for a decade. Nagpur is counted among India's fastest growing cities. He was the king of crime in Kastabunagar. Nobody had courage to stop him from rape the slums women. Every day he was enjoying, but every dog has a day. It was rape that Akhriya Daff used to break and humiliate the community. A rape victim lives in every other house in the slum. He was
in sawalon ka galat jawab.
Targeting the lowest caste of the Indian society. Akhriya Daff was taking the advantage of their caste. In the Indian society, some caste is considered untouchable. Even the local police and advocates ignore their complaints. The same thing happened in the Akhriya Daff case. Some of the low victims of the devil rapist reported to the local police, but the local authorities did not take any action against him. According to the victims, he was bribing the police. He violated women to control men, ordering his henchmen to drag even girls as young as 12 years old to a nearby derelict building to be gang raped. The society was living with a fear of being next victim. A dozens of raped girls reported out of hundreds, but the local police never charged him for rape of even one girl. According to the residents of Kastabunagar, a slum in Delhi, the local police informed the rapist about who want to file police complaint against him, and the devil Yadav would come after her. The local police were hand in glove with Akhriya Daff, because he fed the local officers bribes and drink, and they protected him, and give the freedom to rape the women and young girls. The Indian police were so sincere with the rapist that, when one 22-year-old girl reported being raped by Yadav, the police accused her of having an affair with him and sent her away. Similarly, many others were sent away after being told that you are a loose woman. That's why he raped you. This ignoring behavior of the local police was slowly getting panic in the society and decreasing the respect of rule of law. The residents of the slum had accepted that by law we can do nothing to him. The court will release him again, and the devil rapist will humiliate the families again. In the circumstances they underwent, they were left with no alternative but to finish Akhriya Daff, the devil rapist of Kastabunagar. He raped only poor people whom he thought wouldn't go and tell, or if they did, wouldn't be listened to. In the week before the lynching, people started to talk about taking action against Akhriya Daff. He disappeared, sensing boiling anger of the residents and victims. Within a short period of time, hundreds of residents smashed his empty house to rubble. By the evening, Akhriya Daff surrendered and was in police custody. Akhriya Daff surrendered for his own safety as the residents' anger was out of control. The local police charged him and started court trial. The next day he was due to appear at the city's district court, and about 500 slum residents gathered. After the women protested, the accomplice was arrested and Yadav taken back into custody, but not before he threatened to return and teach every woman in the slum a lesson. The emotions of the victims outburst when they hearing that Yadav was likely to get bail yet again. On the next day of Akhriyad F's hearing, a mob of about 200 victim women came to the court armed with knives and chili powder. As he walked in, Akhriyad F spotted one of the women he had raped. He called her a prostitute and threatened to rape her again. The police laughed. She took her off her sandal and began to hit him. Following her, the victim women's crowd started to beat him with sticks, knife and whatever they want. He was being attacked on all sides. Knives were drawn and the two terrified officers guarding him ran away. Within minutes, Akhriyad F was dead on the courthouse floor. His body was almost unrecognizable as a gory mess, his blood staining the white marble floor of the courthouse. Five women were immediately arrested for the murder of Devil. Then they were released following a demonstration across the city. Now every woman living in the slum has claimed responsibility for the murder of Akhriyad F. The arrested people in murder case of Akhriyad F had been released in 2012 due to lack of evidences. Kindly don't forget to subscribe our channel and like our video. Thank you for watching this video.